you want to win the beauty contest. The homes that sell quickly are the ones that are in pristine condition. If you're in the middle of that, you will stay in the middle. So you want to get yourself up on the top.
You asked about top items that deliver the most amount of money. Clearing out basements and garages, because when you have less stuff in the space, it appears bigger and the buyer's perception is more value. And then we tell them to paint walls and paint floors, even in garages and basements. Mm-hmm. $500 to paint a garage floor, you get your money back 2 to 3 to 1 every single time, and it sells quicker. It makes the space feel cleaner and crisper. And
less is more. And yeah, we say clutter eats equity. So, you know, again, if your home is 3,000 square feet, we want it to feel like 3,500. If it's too full, it can feel like 2,500. So when buyers are looking and they're comparing the homes that they've looked at and they feel that yours is, the flow is good and the space is good and it's neat and clean and orderly, chances are that'll be the one that they will select.
So I think the declutter and the cleaning, if you don't do anything else, those are probably the two best things to do. Landscaping, and it doesn't mean you have to re-landscape your property. It does mean that you have to trim the bushes, you gotta put mulch in your beds. That would also include pressure washing the exterior. So landscaping is the first look. And then on the inside, I would say paint yields the most ROI by far. What we find is that the return on investment is a minimum of 2 to 1. So if you spend $2,500 on paint, you get $5,000 back in sales price, maybe $10,000, and it sells quicker every single time.
I like to recommend a color that's not quite on the cool side, like really gray, but not beige either, like somewhere in between, because this way it can go either way. If the buyer likes more warm tones, it can go towards the beige. If the buyer likes more gray tones, it can go with the cool. So we try to pick something in the middle.
The other thing besides landscaping and paint is flooring. Even if it's new carpet, cleaning the carpets, sheet linoleum, ceramic tile, tongue and groove flooring is now a big thing. To me, that investment is 2 or 3 to 1 on the dollars that you spend. I'm seeing a trend towards more hardwood floors and the engineered hardwoods. You're seeing $2 to $3 a square foot, whereas in a natural hardwood's gonna be $4 to $7.
Yeah, absolutely. Another thing I find with the engineered flooring is when you run the same flooring throughout the whole house, it makes the space look larger. So every time you have a different flooring in a different room, if you have a different flooring in your kitchen, your living room, down the hallway, the bedrooms, there's a break in the flow. And every time there's a break in the flow, it makes the space seem more chopped up and feel smaller. I think kitchens and baths are really important, and not that you have to change all your cabinetry, and there's ways you can paint your kitchen cabinets, you can put new hardware on. There's a process of actually painting countertops, which, you know, we've done that. On a higher end home, we definitely would, you know, recommend to replace that with a hard surface. But there are ways that you can update your home and not have to do a full renovation that will bring you more money for your home. Buyers want to know that they can get in and at least live there 5 years without really having to do a major project. After the 5 years, they can take that on. But you definitely want to make it look current, and there's ways to do that without doing a full renovation.
We don't like to go in and say, hey, you need to spend $30,000 or $40,000 on a kitchen remodel, which you can easily on a high-end remodel. We just want to do just enough to get it in show-ready condition, as Laura says. Because there is a point where when you spend that money, you're not going to get it back in sales price. And I think when you start, you know, ripping out everything and gutting the kitchen, that's where you get into a war that you're not going to win with the money. It just depends on how big the space is and whether you're doing the vanity, the shower, the toilet, the whole nine yards. Sometimes those renovations, if you're redoing, a small bathroom, you could spend $5,000 to $7,000. However, if that enables you to sell the property and sell it quickly and you get $1 for $1 back, that's a good investment.
You never want to block any doorways or windows or even fireplaces. I worked with a seller that had two accent chairs covering their fireplace. You really didn't even know the fireplace was behind that chair until you spread them out. And buyers are buying your features. They're not buying your furniture. So you really want to showcase the features of your home. A lot of times furniture placement will definitely make a big impact on showing off those features too.
We don't back down from that though. We know that our job is to get these sellers the most amount of money. It's a fiduciary responsibility. So we say we really need you to do these things in order for you to get the most amount of money, and that persistence always pays off.